Hey guys, today we are going to discuss about the harsh sounds. I will describe here the left side of the heart. The same mechanism is going into the right side of the heart. If we come into the left atrium, in the left atrium, when the blood enter with the help of the pulmonary vein, when the blood enter into the left atrium, then the 90% of the blood enter without the contraction of the atrium into the left ventricle. But there is a presence of the one valve, its name is a mitral valve. Its name is a mitral valve. Mitral valve is a bicuspid valve. The another name of the mitral valve is a bicuspid valve. The reason of the bicuspid valve is this, that it contains to the two cusps. Another 10% of the blood, with the help of the contraction, the blood enter into the left ventricle. 99% of the blood enter into the ventricle, and blood goes nearly about or slightly movement back, and at that time this valve is closed, meaning that the mitral valve is the closed. The point where the mitral valve is the closed, there is produce of one sound, which name is the S1, and this sound name is a lap. This sound name is a lap. And the same mechanism is going into the right atrium, meaning that when the blood enter into the right atrium, the blood enter into the right ventricle, when the blood will enter into the right ventricle, the slightly move will go back, and at that time this valve will be closed, and this valve name is a tricuspid valve, because this valve contains the three cusps. And when this valve is closed, this also known as S1, mean that this, you can say that both name of this valve is the atrioventricular valve, because that this valve separate the atrium and ventricle in the left side, and the atrium and ventricle in the right side. So you can say that atrium ventricle valve. And the atrium ventricle valve in the left side, known as the mitral valve or the bicuspid valve, and at the right side, this valve is known as a tricuspid valve, because there it contains the three cusp. And when the blood will enter into the ventricle, and then the pressure and the contraction level into the ventricle is a high. The pressure level is a high. There is also present a valve which name is the aortic valve. This valve contains the three cusps. And nearly about when the pressure is going high, then this valve is open, and blood will move from the left ventricle into the blood vessel, and in the left ventricle the blood enter into the aorta. When the blood will enter into the aorta, then the slightly the backflow will occur, and at that time this valve will close, and the name of this valve is the aortic valve. And this valve also contains the three cusps. And the same mechanism is going to the right side of the heart. When the pressure is going high, then the right ventricle contraction occurs. With the help of the contraction, the blood will enter into pulmonary artery, and there is also present a valve which name is the pulmonary valve. And the name of the pulmonary valve and the aortic valve is also known as a semilunar valve. Atrioventricular valve in the left side is the mitral valve, which is a bicuspid valve, and at the right side, which is a tricuspid valve. And the valve which is the semilunar valve in the left side, which is the aortic valve, and on the right side, which is the pulmonary valve. And when this valve will closed due to backflow, that not fluid of the blood enter into the right ventricle or the left ventricle, there's also produce a second sound, which name is a S2. Its name is a S2. And this is known as a dub. This is known as a dub. This sound is known as a dub. And when the blood, with the help of the pulmonary artery, which is the deoxygenated blood, enter into the lungs, contain the deoxygenated blood because it have high concentration of the carbon dioxide, and here the gases exchange occur into the alveoli, and then this oxygenated blood with the help of the pulmonary vein enter into the left atrium, and this, when the left atrium, and without the contraction of the left atrium, the blood will enter into the left ventricle. And sometime in the normal person, this produces the third sound, which name is the S3. And this person, this process is known as a rapid passive filling. Because this is without the contraction of the atrium. This is sometimes in the normal person, and sometimes this is present into the abnormal person. Why? Because that when the volume is the overload, for example, when the level of the in the left ventricle is a high, and the blood is not removed from the left ventricle and not entered into the aorta, why the blood is not entered into the aorta? The reason is this, that the valve is open, and the, when the valve is open, this condition is known as a regurgitation. The regurg means that backflow. Due to the regurgitation or the opening or the defect into the aortic valve or the pulmonary valve, here I'm going to discuss in the left side, and the same mechanism is going on the right side. Due to the defect onto the pulmonary valve, the valve is not closed, the valve remains open, so the blood moves back. This is known as the backflow or the regurg or the regurgitation. Then the blood will move back and the volume will be overload. Due to the volume of the overload, the passive filling will be happen, and this produce a third sound, which name as a S3. And sometimes there's also produced to the S4 sound. Sometimes the S4 sound is a normal in the children or the athlete, but it is abnormal due to the mitral stenosis. We have discussed about the regurgitation. What's the mean of the stenosis? Stenosis means that valve is not closed properly. And stenosis means also that narrowing. When the blood enter into the ventricle, and ventricle pump the blood into the aorta or the into the pulmonary vessel, but when the stenosis occur here, the size is narrow, then atria will contract more, and the ventricle contract more because that the demand of the ventricle is not fulfilled properly. The ventricle will be contract more, and so there is occur concentric hypertrophy. Concentric hypertrophy means that the myofibril cells increase in the size, and when the concentric hypertrophy occur, for example, this one is the normal layer, and when due to the hypertrophy, this one is a hypertrophy, and just this is the remaining ventricle filling. When the contraction occurs, the blood will not properly go to the peripheral organs with the help of the left ventricle or the right ventricle. This nerves produce a third, fourth sound, which name is the S4. This present of S4.
So this was about heart sound.